Hello, dear friends. Good evening to everyone. Tonight is a most special night for all of us because the Spirited Society of Virginia is turning 13 years old. It has been 13 years that God and Master Jesus allowed for us to have the grace of having this beautiful center available to us where we can educate our souls. So we would like to thank God, Master Jesus, and everyone in Jesus's team. This is why we are studying the life of Saint Francis today, because Saint Francis is part of Master Jesus's team, and you and I were also invited to be part of Jesus's team, and the Spiritus Society of Virginia is here to confirm this invitation for each and every one of us and to allow us to join Master Jesus's team, not only now, but forever and ever. So let us open our hearts to be inspired by Saint Francis and to invite our Master to join us. Let us close our eyes and bring our hearts together, thanking God and Master Jesus for bringing so much good to the earth. We thank God and Jesus for believing in the good inside of all of us. We thank Master Jesus for allowing us to reincarnate on the earth again and again, to learn to love and to serve. We thank Master Jesus for the Spiritual Society of Virginia, for Kardec Radio, for all the works of the good, and for everyone in both realms that have worked so hard to allow us to learn for immortality. We thank Master Jesus for inviting us to be part of God's team on the earth. We thank Master Jesus for the opportunity to learn to do the good in every moment of every day. And we thank Master Jesus for inspiring us by sending us so many good teachers. We know that He is the number one teacher that God has sent us, but we also know that Master Jesus has sent us all other great teachers. So we thank Saint Francis for inspiring us to love life and to love nature and to love one another. And with God's and Master Jesus's permission, we begin our lesson tonight. And so be it. So, dear friends, yes, hi Virginia, hi Isabella and Gaby, hi Julia, Stella, and Scott, hi dear Lou. We are receiving a special invitation from God and Master Jesus tonight. They are reminding us that we are incarnated on the earth right now to join his team. How do we join his team? By doing the good and by spreading love. And tonight specifically, Master Jesus is bringing a beautiful team member, Saint Francis, who is also a beautiful teacher, to inspire us to love one another and to love nature, because little animals and little plants are our blessed brothers and sisters. They too are children of God. So, in order to honor God and show our love and respect for God, we are being invited to love our little brothers and sisters animals, plants, and even minerals. Do you want to learn more about how to do that? Saint Francis already knew how to bring love and peace to everyone, including our little brothers and sisters that are growing under the watchful care of God. I would like to know more, and I am sure you would too. So let us enjoy learning more about Saint Francis and how we may learn to love nature all the more. Enjoy, friends.
All the big things start small. So it was with this little seed called Francis, planted by the hands of God in the garden of our time. Francis loved his father very much, a very rich merchant, but did not love his wealth, for he knew that there is no comparison among the treasures of this world and those of the heavens.
A piece of bread, please.
He followed in the footsteps of his father.
Go away.
Even in the bad actions. However, Francis was very kind and had a virtuous mother, Mrs. Picard, who was a pious and God-fearing woman. And in Francis's heart, God was sowing love for the poor.
Thank you, son.
He vowed he would always give something to those who ask for the love of God. Little by little, Francis gave in to the bad examples and customs of that age. But an event changed his life and our history. Spoke to him.
Who can do the most for you? The Lord or the slave?
The Lord.
So why do you turn away from God and follow the slave?
Francis left his plans of vainglory behind and started to praise the Lord in his life. He read the Gospels and was marveled with the deeds of Christ and his apostles. Each day, his love for God and the church, mystical body of Christ, grew inside him. One day, Francis met a sick man, a leper, and he carried a terrifying fear of the lepers. He felt like running. But inside his heart, he felt a great love for the poor sick man and decided to face his fear. With the grace of God and willpower, he went to find the poor man. Then a great transformation happened. What was gall became honey, and the honey, gall. He felt the sweet taste of loving, waiting nothing back, but also felt the bitter taste of wealth, vanity, and the illusion of achieving happiness in the world through material goods. In one of his walks, he found a church in ruins and spent a lot of time praying there. Then one day, something amazing happened. While being in prayer in front of the crucified Christ, the image moved its lips and spoke. "Francis, Francis, do you see my church in ruins? Go and restore my church." Francis quickly ran to his father's store and got money to restore that church. His father, however, knowing that Francis was giving out money to the poor and restoring a little church in ruins, got angry and showed him his disapproval. He did not understand the greatness in his son's heart, who tried to be totally obedient to God.
Oh, you little. How many times I have to tell you?
Francis, full of peace and joy, surprised his father, giving him back all his belongings. Singing and praising God, Francis restored the little church, begging and collecting stones. Just then, he realized that we are the living stones in the Church of Christ, and we were the ones that needed to be restored and get back into the life of holiness. And so began his journey. Preaching the gospel, many followed his example. He was always cheerful and thankful to God for all the creation and treated each and everyone like they were his brothers and sisters.
Since he was a little boy, St. Francis was aware God's love was everywhere.
Through grace and for the glory of God, who lives and reigns for the centuries of centuries. Amen. Saint Francis of Assisi, pray for us.
So hello friends, we're back. So how did you like hearing about the story of St. Francis? Really, really interesting, right? St. Francis, he was so humble. He gave up everything, his life, the closeness of his family to dedicate himself for others. And he dedicated himself not only for other human beings, but he also loved nature, friends. He did. He really enjoyed being outside, being together with the flowers, with the trees, with the animals. You saw on the video, he would walk and the animals would follow him because he was so loving and caring towards nature. So, first question for us today, a quiz question for you. Do you like nature? Do you love nature? I love nature, and I think you do too. Nature is so beautiful, right? It helps us. It maintains our whole planet. Do you know that the trees help our planets breathe? Isn't that really nice? It is very nice, friends, because without nature, we wouldn't be able to be here. So, like St. Francis, today we're going to study more so we can understand more about nature, because we are actually part of nature, all of us together. And we today will understand that we should love and take care of nature, because it is counting on us, like their big brothers and sisters, to be there taking care of them. So, do you want to learn more about nature? Let's study more about nature, friends. And we're going to start talking about a very cute stone, like this stone right here in the mineral kingdom, all the way back. So, let's go to the very, very beginning. Imagine, friends, a very small stone, a little stone. However, this stone, even though it might be so, so small, sometimes, right, you go to the beach and the sand, right? Do you remember feeling the sand in your toes and feet? Oh, it feels so nice. But it's so small, right? The grains of sand, they're so small. But guess what? Those little tiny small particles, they already have a spiritual principle in them. It's like a divine seed. The divine seed is everywhere. So there is a spiritual principle there connected with the mineral kingdom already in that very small grain of sand. Isn't that very nice, right? For us to know that it all is started long, long time ago. But so let's imagine a little seed. So every time we eat an apple, do you eat apples? Wow, I hope you do eat one apple a day. So if we eat one apple a day, we'll be super healthy. So if you eat an apple and you bite, and you will see there is a tiny seed inside. What will happen, friends, if you will go outside and plant that small seed in a beautiful garden? Do you guys know? You can tell me here if you know, but I know you guys already know the answer. If we plant the seeds and we water, we give it water and nutrients, it will grow, right? So that's the same thing as the spiritual principle that is already there inside the grain of sand. It will continue growing and growing, friends. And because, you know, it is everywhere. The spiritual principle is everywhere on nature. So has the little seed, as it grows, it expands, right? It starts as the little seed, and then sometimes you go back. Remember our experiment from a few weeks ago with the little cup and the bean inside? At first, it's just the bean and the little seed. And then you will see it's starting to sprout, right? Starting a little green, a little leaf of green. Yes, that's right, Virginia. Where will go next? It will become to a plant, right? It will go to the next kingdom, to the plant kingdom. So imagine the spirits principle is there. It starts in the mineral kingdom, and then as it continues growing and evolving and progressing, it will go to the next kingdom, which is the plant kingdom. So everything we see, the trees, the flowers, the grass, right? That is all part of the plant kingdom. And they also have that spiritual principle there. It's there and it's growing and growing like us. Remember when you were little, we don't remember, right? But we see pictures. Our mom shows us pictures. Once we were a little baby, so we require small clothes. But what happened? Each year we grow and grow and grow. And can you use the same pair of pants this year that you used a year or 2 years ago? Usually we don't, right? Because we're growing. We need new clothing. And that's the same thing that's happening with the spiritual principle. It is, it continues to go from one kingdom to the other as it's changing, like us changing our clothes. So after the plant kingdom, do you know what comes after the plant kingdom as we go through this internships? Internship is like a training. We're going through trainings in matter. So after the plant kingdom, it comes, you don't, Virginia. So let's see what comes after the plant kingdom. The animal kingdom. Yes, the animals, the birds, the little dog, like this cute dog right here. That's right, Virginia. The birds, the cats, the rabbits, the deer, all these beautiful animals, the polar bear, the penguins, they all come as, remember, so it started like this little tiny seed, right? Remember, in the mineral kingdom, and now the spiritual principle is coming in these different trainings, in the plant kingdom, in the animal kingdom, and it's what? It's growing, right? It's, think about it, it's expanding. It is expanding and progressing. And after the animal kingdom, what comes next? Do you know? What comes after the animal kingdom? Yes, I'm sure you already know. It comes the human kingdom. Us, yes, that's right. So we can think about ourselves as this immortal spirit that many billions, trillions of years ago, we were there in the mineral kingdom, has the very small grain of sand, and then we were continue to grow and grow, and we were changing our clothes. First in the plant kingdom, then in the animal kingdom. And now what, friends? We are in the human kingdom. Isn't that right? Yes, that's really, really, really exciting. So that's right, Virginia. You're right, the human kingdom. But let's understand more, right? We need to study a little more about the different kingdoms so that we can learn to help nature, help what is around us, and care, because they are all our brothers and sisters. So, in the mineral kingdom, let's go all the way back to the little tiny seed, the mineral kingdom. We, in the mineral kingdom, the grain of sand, like here in this picture, this cute friend, we already have inner matter. We have inner matter, and we have what Kardec, our great, great friend, Allan Kardec, explains to us, mechanical energy. So the grain of sand is there. It has matter. Everything is mechanical, right? It doesn't think. It doesn't feel. It's just there, continue to do its job, to contribute to our earth, to our planet. It has lots of mineral, right? That's called the mineral kingdom, because it has nutrients. It helps, right? It helps the trees, it helps the animals, and it helps us. So we depend a lot in the mineral kingdom for everything that we eat, right, friends? We need nutrients. So we need to be so, so thankful, because without our brothers and sisters in the mineral kingdom, we wouldn't be able to survive, right? But remember, the spiritual principle is there. It's okay. It's dormant. It's sleeping still. So not thinking yet. But as we know, it starts to grow and grow. And then it will later go into the plant kingdom. And when we get to the plant kingdom, we see has this beautiful, beautiful tree here. It has inner matter still, but it already has vitality. vitality. That's a big word. So that means that, yes, it has life. It has some senses, right? So the flowers, right, has some, you can touch it, and you know, it feels that we are there, even though it might not really comprehend, right? But we can talk to the trees, we can talk to the flowers, right? They feel our energy, so they need our love and care, but they still don't think for themselves, right? You don't see a tree saying, I don't want to stay here in this side of the garden. I want to go to that side of the garden. You don't see a tree crossing the street or the park and going to the other side, right? Yes, they cannot do that yet, right? They still don't have that ability. However, they know their importance. They have this energy. They are there. They're serving us, right? A beautiful tree like this is giving us oxygen, is giving us fruits, it's giving us the shade so that we can rest. So it is feeling, doesn't feel pain, right? Trees, they don't feel this pain as we feel, right? But this, they have the same sensations, right? They sense that we are there. And as we continue progressing, changing our clothes, and we go to the next one. We go to the animal kingdom, right? So let's see what happens in the animal kingdom, like this cute, cute dog that we have right here. In the animal kingdom, again, we have this inner matter. We have this vitality, right? The vitality is there. The animal has instinct, right? I'm sure that you have gone to the park and you have seen a little squirrel, right? They're so cute here in the United States. They're everywhere. What happened when you get close? You start getting close and close to the squirrel. It doesn't know you, right? It doesn't know yet. It will be a little scared. So their instinct is to run away. So they will run away to the other side, right? That is their instinct because they don't know. Yeah, they're afraid of us. But, right, you start to getting to know more about the animals. But I'm sure you have also seen a dog. And you've seen how a dog behave. It does have some intelligence, right? The dogs are so intelligent. You can teach a dog to go outside, right? To do what they have to do, to sit, to roll. So yes, dogs are intelligent. They have intelligence, but it's different than our intelligence. So it is limited. It's limited intelligence. It's still instinct, right? If someone comes by the door and the dog doesn't know, it will bark, right? That's their protective instinct. They don't know what's out there. It might be a family member. Doesn't mean anyone would do us harm, but they will bark, bark, bark because they're protecting us. So they have this instinct and they have this limited intelligence. And as we continue, right, friends, we are in this journey. Now we will go. What happens? Remember what comes after the animal kingdom? It comes the human kingdom, us, right? We can see how we are progressing between kingdoms. We are changing and we are acquiring new things, new values, right, for ourselves. So in the human kingdom, again, similar to all others, we have the matter, we still have this vitality, right? We have the life inside of us. And different than the animals, we have actually unlimited intelligence. Yes, our conscience is there. And that's why we can do great things, right? We can build airplanes. We can go and travel to space. And we can study. And we can do math, very complicated math that I'm sure our dogs cannot do it, right? So we have this unlimited intelligence. There's no limited friends. It's really interesting, right? So we can study, study, and every time we can learn more. Every day, there's no limits of how much we can learn. So this unlimited intelligence, we also have this knowledge of God. The animals, the plants, and the minerals, they don't have this knowledge of God. But because we have our conscience, we can think, and we know that we are part of something much, much bigger, right? That we didn't create it ourselves. God created us. God is our Father, and He's taking care of us. So, different from the animals, we have this knowledge of God. But that also comes, friends, with a lot of responsibility. We all know we are all responsible for what we do, right? Different than the animals that are this instinct, right? We still have this instinct inside of us, but we are responsible for what we do. So it's great that we have the intelligence, we have the knowledge of God, but we also have a lot of responsibility. So did you enjoy learning about the different kingdoms of nature? Because we're all part of nature, friends. So to learn more, we'll continue our journey. We haven't stopped yet. We still have a lot to learn. So do you want to join me on another field trip? We do a field trip almost every week. So do you guess where we're going this week? Can you guess? Where do you think we will go today since we're talking about nature? A place that we can study more about nature. So bring your binoculars, your pen and paper, and I think we are ready to go. And we will go to a park. Let's go to a park to study nature. Not a better place to go to a park where we have all the different kingdoms of nature there. We have the minerals, we have the plants, we have the animals. So I invite you there, friends, whenever you are, join us in this field trip. And we will do our countdown so we can get ready and go together. And let's start in 3, 2, and 1, friends. Let's go. And today we are hopping on our car, our beautiful, beautiful car to go to our park. So buckle up and let's go. Let's go to the park, friends, so we can learn more about nature. So remember, we have to document our findings because we need to tell our friends later what we learned today in our field trip. Our parents, I'm sure right after this class, they're gonna ask you, what did you learn today, right? What did you learn, Virginia? What did you learn, Isabella and Gabe and Julia and Stella, right? What did you guys learn? Right? So let's do this together. And Scott, I know Scott is there too. Scott, what did you learn today? I'm sure mom will ask. So let's document what we find. And why better not to do that than an ecologist? Do you know what an ecology is? Ecology is a field of science that studies this relationship between the living organisms and their environment. So in other words, they study really the relationship of the different things in nature. So today we'll be an ecologist. So I need you to grab your pen, right? Grab your paper. I know I have mine here to document things. And also invite you to bring your crayons along so that we can write this down, okay? And we cannot forget when we are asked later, what did we learn on class? So this is our beautiful, beautiful, beautiful park. And I know there are many other friends there. So if I didn't say your name, it's just because I don't see you here in the chat, but I know you're there, friends, okay? So you join us in this field trip. So we're in this beautiful park, and let's together look imagine that we're there in this beautiful park, and how we can say thank you to Mother Nature. Say to Mother Nature how much we love them, because we saw, friends, on the previous slides, right, how much work it is to go, right? Can you imagine so many years ago, right there in the Mineral Kingdom, and then you go and you continue changing your clothes, then you go to the Plant Kingdom, and then you continue the spiritual principles there, going to the Animal Kingdom, and until it gets to the Human Kingdom. So we need to show them how much we love them, and we need to cheer them up and say, you can do it, friends. I know you can do it. I'm here and I'm gonna support you. So let's start with our cute, cute friend from the Mineral Kingdom. This tiny grain of sand, the same one that we see when we are walking on the beach. So how do you think we can say thank you for the grain of sand? So let's think together. I'm gonna start making some notes here. And I invite you to do the same. You can draw, you can write, or you can do both. So, for us to say how much we are thankful for the Mineral Kingdom, let's think about what do the Mineral Kingdom, what does it do to help us, right? Well, like this a stone here. Well, if you're there in a park and you have nowhere to sit and you see this really big stone that you can go and you can sit, you can rest, right? Or the stones that we use to build, we can build houses out of it. We can build, we can use it to break it down and create the asphalt that we see, that we put on the ground, right? Oh, wow. 4,000 years ago, Virginia. Yes, that's a long, long time. You see how many years, right? So we need to cheer them up so they continue going, right? They don't give up. That's right. So what else, friends? The Mineral Kingdom contributes because they provide nutrients in our soil for our plants, for our flowers, right? They do. There's so many things that we need in order to build the many things that we have. Where you are sitting right now, right? You are in your home. You might have, you are looking at a computer. Do you know a computer has so many different elements inside of it? So we need the Mineral Kingdom, friends, so that we construct like the foundation, right? Imagine the foundation of a house. We need the Mineral Kingdom there. So I will draw this little cute stone here. That's what I'm gonna decide to do. And you can tell me what you are doing there, because I'm thinking how thankful I am, because so much that we have in our lives, we are thankful to the Mineral Kingdom. So after the Mineral Kingdom, you already know, it comes the Plant Kingdom. So now I want us to, in this park, look around. Imagine you're there in the beautiful park, we're doing our field trip, and we just want to say how thankful we are to this cute tree. Trees are so amazing, right? They are there, and have you ever seen a tree complaining? Have you ever seen a tree complaining about the weather? If it's too cold, if it is too hot, if it's raining a lot and they're getting all wet, or there are thunderstorms that are happening and we want to be inside because we're afraid. Have you seen the tree running inside the house because they are afraid, friends? I have not seen it. So they don't complain, right? They're so loving. You go to sleep and you wake up in the next day and they're still there and they're still giving fruits, right? You see, if you live here in the US, you see that in the fall, what happens? The tree loses all its leaves, right? It falls all down. And you look at it and it's like almost as it's dead, right? Because it's just the trunk and the branches. And you look at it and you can't believe what will happen. But it's getting ready. Isn't it beautiful? The tree gets ready for the winter. And then the winter comes and snow comes. And it gets so cold. And the tree is there, very strong. And then the spring comes and starts to warm up. And then what do you see, friends, when it starts to warm up? Yes, the leaves start to grow again, the flowers. And then one day you walk outside and the tree has all these beautiful flowers, right? Isn't that amazing? So there's so much we need to be thankful for the trees. They also provide us fruit. Remember, we talk about the apple. Why do you like apples or bananas or strawberries? But the plant kingdom gives us all the fruits and vegetables that we eat. So we need to be so, so thankful. They also provide us their trunk, the wood. If you're sitting there in your house, you might be sitting in a chair and you might be putting your computer on a table made of wood. So the tree provides us with that material so that we have a chair and we have a table in our house. Wow, so many things to be thankful for. So to be thankful for all the plant kingdom, friends, what are you gonna write or draw in your, I'm drawing a beautiful, beautiful big tree here because you look at them and I cannot believe so many years that they're still standing them, going strong besides everything that they go through, right? The harsh weathers and the seasons. So I'm gonna use here my green crayon to make the leaves of the trees. How about you, friends? Let me know, what are you drawing there? Before we go to the next kingdom. This tree is looking really pretty. And I'm gonna draw a cute eyes and a mouth in my tree just to remind myself and us that the tree is there. It is not complaining, but it's alive and is so happy and thankful to God. So I picturing my little tree here, smiling to all of us. And the last thing that we're going to study in our field trip today is the animal kingdom. Oh, the animals, are they cute? What is your favorite animal? That's a good question. If you want, you are watching this, you can write here on the comments. What is your favorite animals? We can have so many, right? So hard to choose from. Dogs, cats, we have deer, we have the cute penguins, like they walk like this, so cute. We have the birds, the butterfly. Oh, cats and birds. Great, Daisy. Thank you. Thank you, friends. Yes, so many animals, right? And how we can show the animals how much we are grateful for them to be there. Because if you look at the animal, do you see also an animal complaining? Do you see on TV maybe a polar bear there complaining because the weather is changing in their houses, they don't have where to live? They don't, right, friends? They don't complain. They are so, so loving. And they still provide us with so much happiness, right? If you have a pet at home, a fish, a cat, a dog, a rabbit, a bunny. Yes, a bunny, Virginia. That's your favorite animal? Yes, bunnies are so cute too. So think about your favorite animal and how we can say how much joy they bring they bring to us, right? They're all part of our big, big family. So I'm going to draw my favorite animal, which is a puppy. Yes, I love dogs. I love dogs. I love all animals, but like this cute dog right here, pups are so cute, right? With the little ears, and they look at you with that puppy face. Yes. So I'm going to draw a little dog, and you can continue telling me here what is your favorite animal and what you're drawing there in your drawing. But we cannot forget, friends, that we are all part of this beautiful family of nature that comes from God. So the lesson here for us today is every time that we see nature, that we go outside, that we think about God and how God is so loving that He provides us this opportunity to come has a spiritual principle right there, starting the mineral kingdom, so we can learn. We can learn how to appreciate being many years in the mineral kingdom and then transitioning to the plant kingdom, learning how we can be resilient with the weather, with the change, how we can provide without wanting anything in return, right? That's what we learn in the plant kingdom. We're there, we're helping those around us, and we're not asking for anything in return. And then we go to the animal kingdoms, and the animals, they're helping us with the planet, right? Some animals is providing us food so we sustain ourselves, right? They provide us with the joy of having a pet, or they provide us with this contact with God. You go outside and you hear the birds singing and you think about God. So we have so many things to be thankful. So next time we are in nature, I invite you to think about this and think about how you can show nature that we truly love them. And for me, in the drawing that I'm making here, I'm gonna say thank you to nature by praying. So every time I'm outside, I'm gonna remind myself to pray that God illuminates this beautiful planet that we have in Mother Nature, so that they are there helping and sustaining us, and we wouldn't be anything without nature in our lives. So with that, I'm finishing up here my drawing, and I'm gonna write the word prayer so that I can remind myself to pray next time that I'm walking in nature and being very, very thankful. So I hope you're finished with your drawing. I have mine here. I will show you so you can see. It's how I'm saying that I care for nature by praying. Do you see the prayer turns into little hearts of love for this mineral kingdom, the plant kingdom, the animal kingdom. Here, the little dog, the tree, and the stone. So I can't wait, friends, to see your drawings. Remember, at the end, I'm going to remind you to send your beautiful drawings to us. So with that, we cannot end without our family heart work, friends. So remember, this is an opportunity if you're watching us for the first time. The family heart work is an opportunity for you to continue learning and reflecting on this throughout the week with your family, with your parents, with your grandmothers, with your grandfathers, your siblings. So invite them to join you. And this week, we have two heart works you can choose, friend. Two beautiful heart works. The first one is a movie night. We all love movie nights, right? We do. It's close to the weekend now. So perfect time for a family movie night. Ask your parents to maybe make popcorn, make some good treats, and then you can all sit there and watch on Netflix this documentary. It's called If I Were an Animal. And it's so, so, so cute. You're gonna love it. There's so many episodes. Anything from the sheepdog to a deer to a bunny to so many other animals. And then you can see how their life is and what they do during the day. So you're gonna love, 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 love it, I'm sure. So, and then we have a second heartwork. Yes, a second heartwork, friends, which is a walk in nature. But we have a very, very, very special guest today. Our dear Virginia Diaz, Anceloni Diaz. Yes, Virginia is gonna tell us, explain how we can do this walk in nature as we're talking about nature, to be thankful to God, and how we can help our planet. So we invite Virginia to show us how we can do this family heart work. So I'm gonna stop sharing here just one moment so I can hide myself and we can hear directly from Virginia.
Hi guys, from Kardec Radio for Kids. Today we're learning how to have a walk in nature. And first of all, you are going to need gloves or a trash and a trash bag. Then you go on your street on the sidewalk and walk down the street with gloves and a trash bag with your mom or with your dad or together. Then if you find a piece of trash or anything like trash, pick it up and put it in your trash bag. And three things that you're actually doing: helping the environment around in your environment, you're getting healthier because you're walking. And third of all, you're admiring nature. Thanks, friends, for watching this video. Bye.
Wow, thank you so much, Virginia, for reminding us how we can do this nature walk so that we can help nature, help the environment, and also, as you remind us, be healthy ourselves, right? But being outside, enjoying the beautiful nature, and being healthier, and thanking God for nature in our lives, because we wouldn't be here, friends, if we were not for nature. So we need to cheer up our brothers and sisters there in the mineral kingdom, in the plant kingdom, in the animal kingdom, so they continue going, because they can do it. We did it and they can do it too, right? So
hi,
we invite you now to share your beautiful work with us. Ask your parents to email the Spiritus Society of Virginia is program for youth and children. We will love to see the beautiful work that you're doing there all across our world, because we know we are here in the United States, but you might be there in so many different places, and we want to hear from you and we want to know where you are. So send your beautiful work to us at info@ssvirginia.org. And remember, friends, today we are getting very close to the end of our Miraculous Art Contest. So if you haven't seen this yet, I invite you to join us. We will post later in the comments the flyer again of our Miraculous Art Contest. But we invite you to watch the Miraculous Ladybug cartoon. It's on Netflix. It's also on YouTube. You can watch. There's so many different episodes. And Miraculous Ladybug and Cat Noir, they show to us how we make this mind-to-mind connection through our feelings. And we invite you to draw, make an art. It can be a drawing, you can be a poem, you can be a letter. It depends on your creativity. So the only thing that you need is to link the Miraculous Ladybug cartoon with spiritism or spiritist words. We have some examples here for you. Mind, spiritual influence, spiritual obsession. So think about, watch the cartoon, reflect, think about it, and make this beautiful, beautiful art, and send to us at kardecradio@gmail.com. And the great thing is that all those who submit will win a prize. But remember, there's two requirements, is that you link the Miraculous Ladybug cartoon with spiritism or spiritist words. Their age to participate is 6 to 18, and the deadline is June 30th. So, 2 weeks, friends. Don't forget, less than 2 weeks, a week and a half. So, it's even closer. So, maybe this is a perfect opportunity this weekend to do it. Okay, we can't wait to see the beautiful arts that you will do. And today's lessons, our reference are here. If you have any questions, reach out to us. But if you want to learn more, we invite you to ask your parents to study with you the Spirits book by Allan Kardec. We have the questions here that we use for today's class that talk about the different kingdoms, and also Evolution into Worlds by André Luiz, Psychographs by Chico Xavier and Valdo Vieira. Chapter 3 talks about the evolution in the different phases, the different internships in matter that we go. So now we invite you for a final prayer. As Miss Carol said at the beginning of today's lesson, today is a very special day because it's the Spirit Society of Virginia 13th anniversary. So we have so many beautiful things to celebrate. And one thing is this class right here, the opportunity to be together online. So I now invite you to put down your paper, pencils, crayons, so that we can close our eyes and pray to God. Sounds good? Let's do this. Dear God, we are so thankful in this beautiful day, this very special day, for the Spirit Society of Virginia's team in both realms of life, for bringing to us the opportunity to study and to learn more about Spiritism, and also for sharing those with adults and especially with the children and the youth through this program right here. In this beautiful day where we learn about nature, we learn from Saint Francis how we should value and take care of nature. We pray that our whole planet are enveloped in healing energies and vibrations so that we can tell nature how thankful we are for being our brothers and sisters in this journey on planet Earth, and how much we're thankful for everything that they provided to us every day. We also pray for those who not yet understand the value of nature, and in their actions, they are in some ways hurting our planet. We pray that they can find, dear Father, the joy and the feeling to really appreciate and value our life and nature in our beautiful planet Earth, from the mineral to the plant kingdom, to the animal kingdom. And with your permission, we close this class of today. And so be it. So thank you again for joining us. We are so happy to have you here, and we look forward to seeing you next class in a week from today. And if you have any questions, you can send your artwork or your homework to us, or you can write to us or leave your comments here. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.